the land of the birds of paradise is isolated at many levels, and that's one of the important reasons why 39 species have evolved to be so different. Getting to these difficult to reach places, had to go to so many different mountain ranges, so many different islands. It's all very logistically challenging. And then once you're there, you have to know enough about the birds to be able to find them. And then once you find them, you have to have an enormous amount of patience to be able to be in the right place at the right time. The work really isn't that glamorous. It involves hours and hours of just sitting and waiting and doing nothing other than having your blood sucked by leeches and mosquitoes. No matter where we go, we end up having to hire a whole team of people to porter our gear to the site where we're going to work more remotely in the forest. Sometimes the whole village, the men, the women, even some of the kids are carrying boots and shovels.
Okay, thank you very much.
There's absolutely no way we could even do the work that we do in New Guinea without working with the local people. These people are experts in their homelands. They know where the resources are, they know where different kinds of forests are, and they often know where the birds that we're after are.
While I'm sitting in a blind trying to photograph one species, I'm always aware that I'm just working on one particular bird. Ed is usually spending his time either at other sites observing and documenting, or scouting, trying to find new places for both of us to work.
It's really a division of labor. He's doing the thing that he's a specialist at, that's climbing the trees and getting the photographs in the canopy, and I'm doing the thing that I'm a specialist at, and that's finding other birds, finding other individuals of different species, and deciding where we're gonna work next. Every day we're out there doing the things that we're both the best at. That's why our partnership works.
Oh, it's better than from my angle. At least you're looking down. Well, that's one another advantage of having two different angles, because I'm looking up like that, and I have right. This like bright sunny patch like that right in the background right now.
The fundamental motivation for our work is scientifically driven. It's not simply to have beautiful images or images that can be used to tell the stories we're telling.
Yeah, so check this out.
But for us, it's also an opportunity to understand more about these birds and what they do and how they've evolved and how they've come to be. Everybody out there, whether they're scientists or not, they crave that same kind of feeling, knowing that things exist they didn't know about and getting to experience it for the first time. That's one of the most incredible things about the birds of paradise. They are an example of that extraordinary element of our planet's natural heritage that offers so many rewards for discovery and so many opportunities to see things that haven't been seen before.
The extreme isolation of this region has helped to shape the diverse evolution of these birds. But that same isolation has made it really difficult for scientists to study them. Ed and I see our work as a way to make what was unknown, known. With the birds of paradise, there's always something more to discover.
Were you watching when they flew over there?
I was.
So what was your interpretation? Did they
didn't get anywhere near the spycatchers that were underneath it.